Kristen Cole, do you think your friend is seeking higher office?
Well, I think that she's going to involve herself in whatever different programs and helping other candidates run for election, because I think she resonates with people across this country, ordinary Americans, just like she is. And I think the smaller government, taking personal responsibility, trying to help small businesses, cutting capital gains tax, cutting taxes on small different businesses, all of those things are important to, you know, the small guy, you know, which is the majority of Americans. And so I think she resonates with those folks. We love her, and I think that she will continue to help in whichever arena that she thinks that she can make the most impact for our entire country.
Stephanie, she's going to campaign for Republican conservative candidates all next year.
Yes, I hope so. I hope she has as much success as she did in New York 23. If she can make one race after another implode, then I'm very happy.
You think she's going to hurt the Republicans she endorses?
It seems like it so far, yeah. I mean, the Republicans are having
only
a
one
war
race
within
talking
their own party right now, obviously.
What about that war, Essie? Is she going to contribute to it? Is she going to be a harbinger of it? What do you make of that?
You know, this is a woman who goes on Facebook and writes a note and actually gets policy changed. So I think the sky's the limit for her. I don't have a crystal ball, and I don't know what she's planning. But whatever it is, I'm sure that she'll have a ton of support, just groundswell of support behind her, lots of people rooting for her and helping her. I don't think Sarah Palin needs me or anyone else to defend her. She's just fine.
James, how will she do on the political circuit supporting candidates next year?
Well, I mean, a little mixed bag this year, but look, she's right. The sky's the limit, and there's one sky in American politics, and that's President of the United States. And there's one way that you affect policy, and that's running for president. It seems to me, given the answer today, and I've listened to a friend talk and other people, she's going to run for president. If she is, she's going to be a major force in the Republican Party. People have to get over it. She's very skilled. If you watched her interview today, she's got very skilled at getting a lot better at answering questions and things like this. I suspect that she will run. She does. She's going to get a lot of support out there, and it's going to be an interesting thing. I know I'm going to watch with great interest here. Run, Sarah, run. Go for it.
But how will she be next year endorsing Republican candidates? Will she have a strong impact, James?
In Virginia, and I believe in New Jersey also, the Republican candidates asked her not to come in. She came in New York 23rd, as Stephanie pointed out. That didn't work out very well. You know, if the Republicans are going to have a good year, they're going to have a good year. I mean, Sarah Palin might, affect two or three congressional seats, but I doubt if much more than that. But, a lot of people are not going to want in, but her people, the true believers, the people that she connects with, they don't care. They're for her. They don't care what's in a book. They don't care about anything else. They really for her, and they make up a good part of the Republican Party, and she's got some institutional support out there, and I think she, I hope she runs it. Plus, she's just fun to talk about. I mean, she's always interesting. There's a potential train wreck, and every time there's something going on, I kind of like it. I'm for her. Go for it.
We'll be back with more after this. Don't go away. Kristen, do you want your friend to run?
You know, I do personally, because I think that she can make a huge impact across this country. I think there are a lot of hurting people, and this economic crisis has been serious. And I think we all need to take a step back and look at personal responsibility. And I think that she's the catalyst for that. And I think that she can bring this country together for good and to move us forward out of this economic crisis by, some of the things I suggested earlier, with capital gains taxes being reduced. And do I want her to run? Of course I do. I want our country back. And I think we're headed in the wrong direction. I think there's a lot of Americans that agree with me. So, yes, absolutely, I'd like her to run.
James wants her to run. Stephanie, you want her to run?
Larry, I don't think she's going to come back on your show, because clearly you were being inappropriate and she was about to rip her microphone off and leave. Of all the conservative women books out, I found Carrie Prejean's book more intellectually satisfying. But, I wish Sarah Palin well. I do.
You want her to run?
Yes.
Yes, you do.
I'm with James.
Essie, do you want her to run? You.
Well, of course I do. I mean, you know, if you contrast her to someone like Obama, who's having beer summits and job summits.
No, I'm talking about contrast her to other Republicans who might run. Mitt Romney, Huckabee. Do you want her to beat them?
You want her to
be your candidate?
I don't have any sacred cows just yet. It's a little early, and I don't think she needs a target on her back quite this early. But I'd love to see her run. I think she is completely qualified and able and an inspiring woman.
And James, you wanted to run what, for the fun of it, for the spirit of it? What's your reasoning?
Yeah, of course. Could we sit here for an hour and talk about Mitt Romney? Of course not. I mean, yes. I mean, she's compelling. She's interesting. I mean, I don't think she's qualified able, but she's a lot of other things, which goes to she's one of the most interesting people in American politics. And by the way, but if you want to be vice president, by extension, you want to be president. There's nobody that's ever wanted to be vice president and said, gee, I don't want to be president. I mean, even Dick Cheney's daughter is touting him for 2012 now. I mean, everybody that's vice president wants to be president.
Okay. Let me get a quick call in Miami. Hello.
My question is for Mr. James Carville. What does your latest Democracy Corps survey say about Sarah Palin's approval rating since the book media blitz, sir?
Well, we haven't done one, but there have been any number of polls out. And, you know, a large segment of the Republican Party loves this woman. And they're going to vote for it, and they're going to be for it. Once you get out of that segment of the Republican Party, I have to be honest with you, it tails off pretty good, in fact, drastically. But she's a compelling person.
Hey, thanks, guys. You made the case, James. James Cole, James Carville, Kristen Cole, Stephanie Miller.